Bless the one in prayer. Bless the one in prayer.
Heavenly Father, thank you for allowing us to gather together on this youth day. Thank you so much for these armies of young people that are here before you. We know that the devil is busy, and we know that there is plenty of temptation, plenty of many things that can go wrong in their lives, many things that could attract them to go in the wrong direction. But we want to thank the Lord that they are here in your house this morning. And as long as they are here within our eyes, within our sight, we know that we can perhaps put our hands on each and every one of them and impact their lives in such a way that they will think about the things that they have learned here in this church and things that we have taught them. We are praying earnestly for them. The devil knows that his time is up.
Yes.
And so knowing that, the church can survive only if our young people are still enlisted.
Amen.
Please be with them. Please bless them, bless the families, bless all that are present here and under the sound of my voice this morning.
Yes.
And please remember that our goal is heaven.
Yes.
And please help that when we shall come again, that we'll gather all our youth, their parents, their families,
yes,
and their friends. And we will go home with you one day, for Jesus' sake. Amen.
Most Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love and your mercy. We thank you for your forgiveness and for your power that is within us. We pray, dear Lord, that you will touch each head that is bowed here this morning.
Yes, Lord.
You know their hearts, you know their minds,
yes,
you know what they stand in need of.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We pray in the name of Jesus, who stood in the gap for us,
yes,
that you will bless them, that you will heal them,
yes,
that you will hold on to them, dear Lord, and let them never depart from your sight.
Yes,
Lord. Many times we feel like letting go and just turning our backs. Lord, you have never done that to us.
Thank you, Lord.
And
thank
I know you, what these young people are going through day by day.
Thank you, Lord.
You know the struggles that they are having in their lives.
Yes, Lord.
Things that they may not share with us.
Yes, Lord.
Because you know their hearts and their minds.
Yes, Lord.
Help them to come to you, Lord. Hold on to them, dear Lord, and comfort them. Let them know that you will never leave them and that you will never forsake them. Continue to bless this church, dear Lord. Continue to bless the leaders. Continue to keep them in your care. Continue to help them to have a single focus, and that is heaven. Knowing that, dear Lord, I know that we all will one day we come and go home with you.
Yes,
it's my prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we pause yet a little longer to thank you for thy transforming power and thy tenderest mercies.
Yes.
Thank you for the prayers of Sister Johnson and Sister Graves.
Yes.
Thank you for their presence, for their commitment and dedication towards the service of saving young souls. Pray a special anointing in their lives that they will continue to be the leaders you have called them to be. Father, back home here, we want to lift up one of our family members, Elder Noel and his family. Father God, there is sickness in the extended family, and we continue to lift up Sister Nicole and other family members that are not in the best of health. Lord, we pray that your healing power will just touch that racked body, touch the mind, touch the physical being, so that they can be restored to wholeness. Continue to strengthen the Noel family. Keep them ever faithful, vigilant, and focused in spite of what they are passing through. There are so many of us here in the family, Lord, that is passing through setbacks, disappointment, some of us are passing through the valley of the shadow of death, emotionally, spiritually, physically. But you have said in that beloved psalm that is known by all, that even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will be with you. What a blessing and a promise to know that you will never leave us nor forsake us. So in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray now that those souls in the family of the living God who are depressed, perplexed, and confused, may we continue to cast all of our cares upon you, because you care for us. Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Jehovah Nissi, our peace. Father God, we pray for peace in the midst of the storm. Whatever our storms are in life, we pray that you will be our anchor. Father, we lift up the young people who are in service today. May they not see this as another day on the platform and on the program to get things done for the year, but may they see this as a place where God has called them to be lighthouse, to be a lighthouse, and to be witnesses. Bless each one that is participating today. We pray for our visitors. It is no mere accident that they're here. Grant them this day's blessings. We lift up our pastor, that you continue to keep him under the shadow of thy almighty arms. I pray that you'll continue to break his heart and help him to be the visionary you have called him to be. We pray for the young people that will present not just the reading, but the word. We know we will receive the word because we have come to hear from you. We thank you for thy presence, and we pray that when all is said and done, may all of us in the family will be found, not one missing, and if perchance we can snatch a family member out of the fire, grant us that privilege of saving our family.
Burdens are lifted at Calvary.